Shoulder injuries are extremely common, as it is the most mobile joint in the body, making it more prone to injury. Today we're going to show you why shoulder impingement is the most common cause of shoulder pain, as it accounts for an astonishing 44 to 65% of all shoulder complaints. The shoulder joint is a highly mobile ball and socket joint, consisting of the humeral head and the glenoid cavity. However, there is a slight trade-off. Because the shoulder joint is the most mobile in the body, it lacks stability. This is due to the humeral head being quite large in proportion to its socket, so it's not what we'd call a perfect fit. Before we get into the potential cause, we must first understand the anatomy. The rotator cuff is a group of muscles located at the back of the shoulder, which play an important role in maintaining stability by preventing excess movement of the humeral head. These muscles include the supraspinatus, the infraspinatus, the teres minor, and the subscapularis. But due to excessive overhead activity, abnormal postures, and poor biomechanics, this can cause certain muscles to be too strong while others are too weak, causing the humeral head to be no longer positioned optimally within its socket. This is where soft tissue structures such as bursa or rotator cuff tendons can get impinged or trapped, in a space called the sub-acromial space, located between the humeral head and the acromion. If left untreated, this can lead to chronic pain, tendinopathies, and even tears. But the good news is, a few simple exercises can help strengthen those muscles and fix your shoulder pain. Stay tuned for the next part of the series, where we will be showing you the latest evidence-based treatment for your shoulder pain. I hope you found this information useful. Thank you for watching. Remember to like and subscribe. See you next time.